Before this video, I had no idea how the internal combustion engine works. And now, I still don't know. Wrong line. But I'm going to explain it to you in simple terms. First and foremost, you need to prepare a working mixture. You need to make sure it easily ignites and expands due to increased temperature, pushing the piston. For that, we need a device called a carburetor. I'm going to simplify the description greatly, because it is an engineering marvel with many screws, adjustments, valves, and so forth. So the carburetor is a tube of varying diameter. It's wider at one end and narrower in the middle. This part leading to the engine. From here, the air comes. In the middle part, there is a little tube that dips into a vessel with the gasoline. This is the gasoline. Here, where the tube exits into carburetor, there is a teeny little hole. It is so small that even a sewing needle wouldn't fit. It's a fraction of the millimeter in diameter. This tiny little hole is the carburetor Achilles heel, and God forbid it gets clogged. Basically, the engine is a unique pump. If we start the internal combustion engine, it will suck the air from this side. Here, the air speed is higher, and here, it's lower. Let's take two pieces of paper. I'm going to blow between them to see how they behave. Okay. You see? They're trying to stick together. That's because the air between them has a higher speed than the outside. That means that the pressure outside is atmospheric, and the pressure between them in the middle is lower than atmospheric. The same applies here, to this narrowed area. Under the influence of this pressure, gasoline rises up the tube and reaches this little hole, exiting it as a tiny droplet. It's a mixture of gasoline vapors and air, at the ratio of 1 to 15. Now, onto the engine. There is a cylinder and a piston, flywheel, crankshaft, and the connecting rod. On one side, there is an intake valve. Fuel from the carburetor passes through the intake valve. And this is the exhaust valve, which further releases the spent working mixture through the exhaust pipe. On top, there is a hole into which the spark plug is inserted. And the piston moves down and draws the working mixture from the carburetor into the cylinder. It is called intake. Next, we close the intake valve and do not open the exhaust valve. The piston moves upward. This stage is called the compression. At this very moment, the pressure increases tenfold. Temperature rises from 50 degrees of Celsius to 300. During the ignition, the spark from the spark plug further expands the working mixture, increasing the pressure to 30 atmospheres and the temperature to 2500 degrees of Celsius. This heated working mixture again moves the piston down, performing work. And this is called the power stroke. All valves are closed during this stage. And in the end of the power stroke, the temperature drops to 1400 degrees and pressure drops to 6 atmospheres. Then the burned mixture must be released through the exhaust valve and exhaust pipe. The piston moves upward again, expelling the air. The pressure drops to 1.1 atmosphere. At this very moment, in a car without a muffler, you hear a pop. And so the cycle continues. I've shown you the working principle of just one cylinder, while the modern engines usually have four or more such cylinders. I hope you enjoyed the simplification of the world of engines. Live long and prosper. And don't forget to subscribe.